Hello chess friends and welcome to the channel. I'm back with a new game played 2 days ago at the online chess Olympiad. I'm also glad to introduce you a very nice chess personality. Her name is Qiyu Zhou from Canada, 21 years old. She is a national master with an high rating, almost 2300. She won the Canadian Women Championship in 2016 and she studies in university. But not only that, she is also a strong Valorant player, one of the best new Battle Royale video games, and you can find her playing chess, video games, and talking about stuff on Twitch. Of course, I will leave you all her contacts in the description below the video. She also appears many times with the funny bot sister, so maybe many of you already know her. She is beautiful, smart, she is also a good girl, and that's why I like to show her on my channel. The game that we are going to watch together is Markantonaki versus Joe in the match Greece versus Canada played 2 days ago. Let's get started. Difficult game for Qiyu Zhou. With the white pieces, the white player Haritomeni Markantonaki opens with e4. Black answers with e5, knight to f3, knight to c6, bishop to b5, and we are in the Ruy Lopez. a6, attacking the bishop, is the Morphy defense. Bishop back to a4, and now knight to f6, attacking the central pawn. In the main line, white doesn't protect the pawn, because short castle is the best move, probably. Bishop to e7 is the characteristic move of the closed Ruy Lopez. Now, really, it's time to protect the pawn. Rook to e1, and now that black is only one move from castling, she can safely play b5 that will force this light square bishop to this diagonal, so watching f7, but as we said, there is no problem for black. Watching f7 doesn't scare black, that can castle if needed. Here comes d6, c3, sorry, let's go back one move, d6, after d6 there is also on the board this idea, knight to a5 to win the bishop pair. That's why white continues with c3, that will support the central push d4, but also is giving this c2 square to the bishop. Short castle for black, and in this position h3, played immediately before d4, will prevent the annoying bishop to g4. In practical play, scores better than d4 played by the white player. In fact, Qiyu immediately plays bishop to g4, attacking and pinning the knight, and here comes d5. d5, very interesting line. This is the line of the great attacking players Gashimov, Gata, Michael Adams, and many others. The knight moves to a5, attacking the bishop, bishop back to c2, and now c6, attacking the head of the pawn chain. h3 first, bishop back to c8, and now d capture on c6. The knight recaptures on c6, and it's time for white to develop the queenside. Knight in b goes to d2, g6 is a novelty, and the game is now original. Knight to f1, the classic knight maneuver. Rook to e8, because of course the idea is to bring the bishop in fianchetto. Knight to g3, played by the white player. I don't like very much this move, because with g6 that is controlling both the outposts, it seems to me that is more logical, knight to e3. Now, bishop back to f8 and a4. Rook to b8, because of course before, black must pay attention, because this capture is a real threat, because the a6 pawn is pinned to the rook that is unprotected. So rook to b8, a captures on b5, and now a captures on b5. Bishop to b3, there is probably also this idea of this knight jump. So here comes h6, controlling g5. Bishop to e3, and now bishop to e6, challenging the light square bishop on b3. Rook to a6 is attacking the knight, queen to c8, defending and attacking, and now rook back to a2. King to h7, bishop captures, queen captures, and now queen to a1. Queen to a1, there is two heavy pieces on the a-file, so Qiyu Zhou brings back the queen to c8, because of course she wants to protect the queen side, but probably this move is a bit passive. Let's go back one move, let's watch a very nice alternative before, and with this move, Black immediately equalizes the game, because the pawn can't advance, there is the queen, and even worse is to capture, because capturing on c4 loses the game on the spot. Knight recaptures on b4, comes with tempo, and so white will lose material, because after this move there is another knight jump that is a fork, so the heel change is lost. Let's go back to our game. Instead, after queen to a1, Black continues with queen to c8, but of course let's remember that this is a rapid game, so there is no much time to play the finest moves. After queen to c8, rook to d1, watching the backward pawn, rook to a8, and now knight back to e1, queen to b7, connecting the rooks, and now an inaccuracy by the white player, rook captures on a8. I don't like that the white player gives back the a-file to the black rook. The rook recaptures on a8, queen is under attack, queen to c1. Knight to a5, the idea is probably to jump to c4. Here comes f3, cementing the pawn structure, and now knight to b3, attacking the queen. Is another move that I don't like. Much better knight to c4. Now the queen moves to c2, attacking the knight. And now knight to c5, but it was better to accept that this knight to b3 was not so good. Bring back the knight to a5, and then relocate the knight to c4. But here comes knight to d3. Probably another inaccuracy that gives Black the chance to get rid of this knight not well placed on c5. Now, of course, I understand that d3 is the best square for this knight, but there is to wait. Much better king to h2, away from the back rank, and also protecting the knight. And then let's watch what Black will play. Anyway, after knight to d3, Qiyu Zhou, he changes the knight. Knight captures, queen captures, but b4 play now is not so good like before, because there is c4, b3. Of course, Black doesn't want the connection of the pawns. And now, knight back to e2. Knight to d7, and knight to c3, probably knight to b5 is coming. So, a third attack against the backward pawn. Difficult position, especially because we are at move 35, so there is very little time to think. In this position, white is better, and this is the first critical moment of the game. Qiyu immediately adds a new protection to this pawn, playing queen to b4, but knight to b6 is the best idea. Queen to b4 is a mistake, because the queen was protecting the rook. Now there is a terrible fork on d5. If white finds queen to d5, and watching the colors of the arrows, you understand that the Greek player didn't find this move. This is really a terrible fork, because the rook is under attack, and also f7 that comes with check. Rook to d8, protecting, bringing the rook away from this attack, and also protecting the knight, is one of the best continuations for black, but this position is lost, because there is queen capture on f7 with check, bishop to d7, the knight jumps to d5, there is a second knight jump, and this g6 is under attack. It's not possible to protect it, or it's very difficult to protect this position. For Stockfish is plus 11, so it's game over. But let's go back to our game. Now the pawn is protected, but queen to d5 wins the game. Instead, here comes knight to d5, attacking the queen. White is still better, but this is a great missed opportunity. Queen to a4, and now rook to c1. Queen to a2, attacking the pawn. Queen to c3, and now rook to c8. King to h2, knight to c5. Bishop captures, rook captures, and now rook to d1. Watch that the backward pawn can become a target, because the knight can jump to f6 with check. This is always a threat that we must consider, and then jump away, attacking the defender of the backward pawn. So it's also possible that white can change the knight on this bishop. So here comes queen to a6, a double attack against c4. Now in this position, white should capture the pawn, because after queen capture, not played by the white player, there is rook captures on c4, but now queen to d3, attacking and pinning the rook. Black must unpin the rook. Probably in this position is also possible to change the queens, because this endgame, in this endgame, white has a good knight versus a bad bishop. So after queen to b1, if black changes, is game over. Best move is to stop this pawn with queen to b3, but now rook to d3 will come, and there is some advantage in this endgame for the white player. Now, of course, I don't know if in a rapid game at move 40 something is possible to convert this technical endgame, but anyway, this is probably the best line. Let's go back to our game. After queen to a6, white brings back the knight, protecting the pawn. This is too passive. Now queen to a4 and rook to d3, with a chance to capture on b3. But after h5, white changes idea and plays rook to d5. This is a mistake, and the game is now equal. Bishop to h6, rook capture, d capture, and knight to d5. There is always this annoying, important check. So bishop to g7, controlling f6, and here comes h4, that is a good practical move, so giving some space to the king. Queen to a2, because Qiyu wants the counter player on the queen side. Knight to b6, and now f6. Knight to d7 will win c5, for example. Here comes instead knight to d5, but of course now this is a blitz game, so some inaccuracy. Bishop to h8, and now queen to d2. Bishop back to g7, queen to c3, some repetition to gain time on the clock. Bishop back, and then knight to c7. Bishop to g7, knight to e6. This move should be winning, because it's not possible to protect the pawn. Bishop to h6, and in this position, here comes knight capture on c5. The pawn was won, but let's go back one move. Now in this position, there is something much stronger, because queen to d3 with the idea of queen to d7 check should be winning. Instead, white continues, but we are at move 54. Knight captures on c5, less strong than this queen to d3, queen to d7 idea. And now a bishop to f4 with check. G3, closing this diagonal, so shielding the king and attacking the bishop, is the best answer, but now there is a weakness on the second rank. Qiyu brings back the bishop to h6, not the right move. Let's go back, but now I will show you the best idea, but in my opinion, it's impossible to find it without time, because best idea in this position is queen to a7, very difficult to find, that is attacking the knight, but also attacking the weakness of the king. This knight can also move back to d3, protecting f2, but we will watch the best line for white. We will understand why knight back to also knight back to d3 doesn't work for white, because there is always bishop capture on g3 with check. So now best line for white is queen to b4, that is protecting the knight, keeping this diagonal close, but now there is a bishop capture on g3 with check, and if white captures the bishop, there is queen to a1. If queen capture on b3, there is queen to e1 with check, king to g2, and this will become perpetual check. And going back to our queen to a1, if queen to d2, trying to protect a bit everything, also this becomes a draw, because there is queen to g1 with check, that it's a fork, and of course this endgame is a draw. So let's go back to our game. Instead, after g3, black brings back the bishop to h6. Now queen captures on b3. If Qiyu changes the queen, it's game over. So she plays queen to b1, trying to find the counterplay against the queen side, but more than that now against the king. Now queen to c3, because this invasion is a bit scary, but let's go back one move. Queen to b7, we check, is the winning idea. King to g8, queen to d5, we check. King to h8, no problem about this check, and later we will watch why. Queen to f7, we check. Bishop to g7, knight to e6, with checkmate in one that it's impossible to stop. Queen capture on b2, we check. Doesn't scare white, because after king to h3, there are no more checks. So let's go back to our game. Queen to b1, brava Qiyu, that with this invasion and the connection of the bishop and the queen, she is scaring white, that becomes passive. Queen to c3, queen to f1, queen to c2. This is a terrible mistake, and now black is winning. Bishop to e3 is a sort of fork, because he's attacking the unprotected knight, but also threatening bishop to g1, we check, sorry, that will push the king under the x-ray attack of the queen. So white saves the knight, but not the king. Bishop to g1, we check. King to h1, all the move, but now this is a fork checkmate. Bishop to f2, discover a check. King to h2, queen to g1, we check. King to h3, and now there are two checkmates. Queen to h1, or queen capture on g3, played by Qiyu Zhou, and black wins the game. So quite a fight, and also very good comeback for the Canadian player. Let me know in the comments below the video if you already knew this girl, and of course if you like the game and the video. Don't forget to like the video and to subscribe to the channel. Thank you very much for watching, and see you tomorrow with a new game. Goodbye.